Hello promising traders, Alex here from promisingtrader.com with DigiByte on my chart. Let's begin the 10 minutes analysis. Today is the 29th of October and it's nearly 8 a.m. in the UK. It's actually 8 minutes to 8 to be more precise, as you can see in here. Okay, this is an alert that I have made for myself because I trade Forex in this very moment. But it's fine, I will check later. The alert only works if you use TradingView, the pro version, because otherwise you don't have alerts, which I would recommend you to do. You can find the link in the description. Obviously, the free version is good, but if you want to save time, if you trade and want to save time, that's really a time saver, because now I know I may have a look at that and check whether or not I want to enter a position. Anyway, I will check later. So, monthly view of DigiByte. This is only paper trading advice. Never put your money where I'm saying money may go. Look at the volume compared to the beginning on DigiByte is almost dead. Look, boom, boom, boom. It's absolutely nothing. Obviously, if we ignore that part, we will see the volume scaled. And like I have been told in a comment, yes, DigiByte has not much volume. The volume is dropping. People are not trading, which is a good sign. When DigiByte or whatever, not only DigiByte, when any instruments or securities reach kind of the bottom, because people are not trading it anymore, because people have lost faith and they have sold it, possibly after buying in this area because of the news, which is why I'm a trader and I'm not doing any of these things. I just try to evaluate the possibilities, the probabilities to be right against the ones to be wrong. I enter a position, and the difference between trading and gambling, which I explain in another video, which is in the Successful Trader Survival Kit playlist that you can check on my channel. If you are gambling, if you are playing, I don't know, at the casino, whatever you put in the slot machine or whatever, if you lose it all. In this case, if you lose, you can choose how much you want to lose before you call it. Okay, that's the big difference. And so if you are able to manage your capital, you are profitable on a long term, on a long run, which is the difference. It's a huge difference between trading and gambling. Okay, so yeah, there is a component of gambling indeed, but it's not exactly the same, because you control what you do. You control your money. You don't control the market, unfortunately, but you control your capital. And because you can only be 50% wrong, of the 50% of the time wrong, if you manage your capital wisely, it's not gambling, it's actually very profitable, but you must know what you're doing. Anyway, monthly view, as I said, there's only a drop of the volume. RSI is still decently nice, it's above 44. It's not bullish, but it's not completely bearish. It's not, if it goes below 40, I'm afraid it will keep dropping. And but otherwise there are chances that it goes up. Let me check the weekly. In the weekly, after the bullish engulfing candle, we had a retest, which was expected. However, RSI is still not very high, and MACD, it's about to make a crossover, but will it make it? We don't know, because we need to wait until next Monday to see whether or not there is, or at least until next Monday to see whether or not there is a crossover here. So we need to try to figure out if it's going to do it. And if we check the daily, actually, it doesn't look very much bullish anymore. I mean, RSI, it is indeed approaching the 50. It dropped. MACD, it didn't want to make any crossover, meaning it's not completely confident, this market. And if we check in the 6 hours, actually, we find a bunch of bad reversal signals in this area, just at the 233 EMA. Not only, we didn't manage to see the DigiByte crossing over the 55 EMA in the 6 hours. And most importantly, now that I reveal my mess, there should be also something different that I, okay, we just need time. We didn't manage to close this window, actually. Yep, no, nothing. I saw this one, but this one is not a window that concerns me. Well, actually, yes, it is also this one now, to be honest. So there is another window that we want to close. Now, two windows to be closed before call it bullish again. And at the moment, it may go up. I don't see any actually reversal signals yet, so chances are it may drop even more. But I was telling you should expect DigiByte to go at least in this area of 0.0070-ish, and also maybe trading between these two, so the 0.007-ish and the 0.0066-ish. Okay, it would be very normal. Now, we don't want to see DigiByte making a new low. So if DigiByte goes below this one, yeah, I mean, there is still the hope to make the retest of this area, but this area, in my opinion, should not be retested anymore. We want to now, we had the retest of this low here, and now we want to see DigiByte trending up. Obviously, this uptrend will not all the way abruptly just revert. So there will be ups and downs because that's the way the market moves. Okay, but we need, looking forward to make all these trades now, but we need to see first closing this window here in the 6 hours, which is again in the region of the 0.0076. Okay, this one here, we need to see the price going above this green line here, this gap that we can see here. And then we also need to see the price going above this, which literally in this moment means closing above that 233 EMA. Let's see what we can find out if we go into a shorter time frame. In a shorter time frame, we at the moment are having a nice candle. But we had nice candles even here, and they didn't really work very much. But here, we have it's not beautiful, but still, along with the previous bullish reversal signals here, bullish patterns here, it may say something. And so this is an inverted hammer and also a piercing pattern. So if I just go and tell my candle scanner to just filter. I don't know which one should I filter. Let me filter the inverted hammer. You see, we have a piercing pattern, which is good. There is rejection. Now, everything depends. By the way, you can get my candle scanner if you use TradingView. You just need to join the Promising Traders tribe, and along with that, I will give you strategies and things if you ever want to trade. It's promisingtrader.com/join the tribe, all in one word. It's also in the description and in the pinned comment down there in the video. So the piercing pattern, the inverted hammer actually needs a confirmation. So we need this new candle here to close above the closing price of the inverted hammer. But this also is a piercing pattern. However, with DigiByte, you know, it's not completely, these candles don't necessarily work. So we need to see them more in context than with any other securities. However, if we check RSI and MACD, RSI looks like it's flat here. It's trying to break the 50 again, but it's trending down. MACD is actually showing a kind of reversal upwards, but it's not enough for me. It's a little bit of a hope, I would say. We need to see what happens with this new candle, but it's going to happen in 1 hour. And it may revert now, but yeah, we have a bunch of reversal signals if we go in the hourly time frame, and we can see that RSI is actually trending up. What I'm not sure though, is it going to be enough? Because if it closes above this one in the hour, it doesn't make much of an impact. It needs to happen in the 6 hours, remember? So these two green areas need to be closed in the 6 hours, not in the hour. In the hour it can close, but in the 6 hours it will result just like a shadow. So it's not necessarily good. But all these inverted hammers are actually closing above the previous. Actually, the next candle is closing above the inverted hammers. We have piercing pattern, bull engulfing. So it looks good. After the crossover of the 233 EMA, now it's just flirting with it. It may keep going up, actually, but I wouldn't really completely be sure. I mean, the chance that it drops are still there, and I wouldn't enter any position, to be honest. If you point me again to the head, then again, because there is so much support here, I may probably put a stop loss here and I would wait. But we really need to have a closure above the first red line, which is 008. So I don't know. I wouldn't trade it, to be honest, right now, if it's possible to trade it. Let me go to DigiByte Bitcoin, which is actually probably the most interesting of the two for the traders. Because you, if you are on Poloniex, like in this case, you may, you may actually enter and exit, so move money from here to Bitcoin or Ethereum, but in this case it's Bitcoin. So let me go to the daily, because I'm forecasting something nice in here, but not yet, actually. According to what I see, we will see Bitcoin going up again. I look like that just by watching this, and therefore this one is going to drop. It's not bullish yet, so yeah, we need to test more of these support areas. However, the bottom is going to be this if we didn't manage to have the price staying above, or at least in this line, not closing below it. It will keep dropping, but I'm very optimistic. I think it's just a momentary thing, and then it's going to resume the uptrend. Okay, so I think I've said everything I had to say. Please let me know if you enjoyed the video, what you want to know, what you want to see, because I usually deal with trading things, and with DigiByte I don't. But if you have questions about wealth, how achieving your goals with these kind of things, please let me know, because I may still be useful to you with other information, because I've got a video, which I have to do, but I never find time to make, about how to keep the wealth that you may generate with this stuff, which probably is interesting to you. But yeah, please let me know. Let me know what you think about that video, if you want to see it or not. Anyway, thank you for watching. I wish you a great day, and I will see you tomorrow with another update. Bye-bye.